As the European football governing body, UEFA is committed to the development of girls and women's football in all of its affiliated 54 member associations. Europe boasts over 1.2 million registered female footballers, a five-fold increase over the last 20 years. But when did it all start for the women's game?
There were some countries earlier than others. England, Sweden played the first Euro final back in 84. So I think the center of the start was actually the northern part of Europe, I would say. Although the first professional teams were in Italy, already in the beginning of the 80s, actually.
When I was a kid, my first year, with 5-6 years, I was to practice and I went to the games with my boys' teams, but I couldn't play because I was a girl.
Participation is now high thanks to the ongoing improvement of women's football and the high level of competition, which has seen iconic moments inspire future generations.
Quite a breakthrough was maybe when Germany won the Euro back in 89 with a full house in Osnabrück, I think it was.
I would say that it has been growing in the past very, very fast since we have those strong leagues here in France, in Germany and in Sweden.
L'intensité a beaucoup augmenté et ça fait que le spectacle est encore plus passionnant, je dirais.
I've always said that competition drives development. And we see now when we have 47 teams participating in the women's team, we have the same amount playing in the under-17. And it's the same with the Women's Champions League. It was quite a pressure from the associations to start also a club competition at that time.
La Ligue des Champions est un exemple qui montre que voilà, l'UEFA a vraiment envie que le football féminin de haut niveau continue à progresser.
The future is about building on those foundations. The Women's Football Development Programme aims to develop grassroots, female coaches and the promotion of the game. Progress is strong, but what comes next could take women's football to a whole new level.
We need much bigger grassroots. It is big and growing in some of the European countries, and in many countries it's growing almost everywhere. But it's still room for more girls to play.
You can even earn your living on soccer. And you know, when I started, it was impossible in Sweden, first of all.
There is a great future. I'm sure that in the next years, our sport will grow up even more and it will be a better situation for all the young girls.